Now, if you're going to integrate real-world measurements into RF design, those measurements are only as good as the fidelity of the hardware that they are acquired on. So to tell us a little bit more about what we're doing in that space, I'd like to bring up Director of RF R&D, Jin Baines, and Product Manager, Rajat Lal. What's up, guys? Hey, Jin.
Yeah. Welcome. Good to see you.
Rajat. Okay, welcome, guys. Jin, tell us what you and your team have been up to.
Well, we've been really busy lately expanding our RF platform and our portfolio of products. In particular, we've actually been taking the frequency range of our signal analyzers and extending that out. Back in 2002, we released a 2.7 gigahertz signal analyzer. It was a low-cost analyzer. More recently, in 2008, we released a 6.6 gigahertz analyzer, which was a fast-tuning system. Now, today, I am very proud to announce the release of the NI5665 14 gigahertz signal analyzer.
Awesome.
Cool. However, we have not only been focused on extending the frequency range, we've actually been really focused as we set the charge to develop this product to create the best-in-class product. And that means in terms of RF performance, such as linearity, TOI, noise floor, and phase noise. We believe that with this product, we've achieved that goal.
So best in class is a pretty bold statement, so you gotta prove that, right?
Yeah, and I don't use those words lightly at all, Eric. We really mean it. This product, we believe, if you look at it compared to some of the top of the line products out there, is really up there in terms of performance. Most engineers would say that Rohde & Schwarz and Agilent have products that are top of the line in terms of signal analysis. Well, some would say that the Agilent PXA is the best product out there. We figured, what better way to show the performance of the 5665 than to show it against the Agilent PXA? So here, we actually have a demonstration that will pit the 5665 up against Agilent's PXA product. With that, Rajit, please walk us through the demo.
Absolutely. So for the first test, we're actually generating two tones that are spaced 1 megahertz apart with sender frequencies close to 10 gigahertz.
Now, wait a second. So 10 gigahertz is higher frequency than we've typically had in generation. So that's one of the Phase Matrix products, right?
Yeah, you're absolutely right about that, Eric. These are synthesizer modules from Phase Matrix using their QuickSyn technology. These are products that go up as high as 20 gigahertz. They have very good phase noise performance, generate really clean tones, which is exactly what we wanted for this demo.
So describe the rest of the setup then.
Absolutely. So what you're seeing on the screen are the two spectrums acquired by the Agilent PXA and the NI5665. You will notice that both instruments have world-class dynamic range and are measuring about 73 dB at the 10 gigahertz. For the next test, I'm going to generate a WCDMA signal using an NI vector signal generator and measure adjacent channel power, or ACP, measurements on both instruments. Here again, you will notice that both instruments are displaying world-class performance and are measuring almost negative 81 dBc on the upper and lower adjacent channel power measurements. However, the Agilent PXA is taking about 430 milliseconds to make the measurement, whereas you will notice the NI5665 is taking only 30 milliseconds, making us almost 15x faster right out of the box.
So 15, yeah, that's cool. That is way better than 10x, so that's impressive. And so how do we get that level of performance?
Since the 5665 is a software-defined instrument, all of the processing, such as the FFTs, the averaging, even the modulation and demodulation are done on the host PC, which in this case is the really fast 8133 controller featuring an Intel i7 processor. But you know what? We can get faster. I also have an NI Flex Rio instrument in my PXI chassis, which features an onboard FPGA that can be used for real-time decision-making capabilities. In this case, we're going to move the processing from the host PC onto the onboard FPGA. Let's go ahead and make that change. Now you will notice that instead of 30 milliseconds, we're making the same measurement in 2 milliseconds, wow, making us almost 230 yeah, times faster.
That's cool. Yeah. Yeah, that is ridiculously fast. Okay, so let me recap. So same performance or slightly better than the PXA in terms of RF performance. It's 15 times faster out of the box. You add some embedded FPGA programming, and it's over 200 times faster.
Oh, we're also 1/10 the size and a fraction of the cost.
Okay, now you're dangerously close to bragging.